Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. In the previous update, we thoroughly analyzed the quadruple conjunction from the 15th to the 17th of March, and we estimated very strong to major seismic activity around the time of those planetary conjunctions. And as you can see, early on the 16th already, we had a magnitude 7.1 earthquake, and that was at the Kermadec Islands. And on the 18th, and that was the time that we actually anticipated the largest seismic activity, a magnitude 6.8 occurred near the coast of Ecuador, and unfortunately, there were also fatalities. So as you can see, we estimated a possible seismic increase starting on the 16th, and then the largest seismic activity potentially around the 18th. In this case, it was actually the other way around. The largest seismic event was on the 16th, and then another strong to major earthquake on the 18th. But this is the relationship between the larger earthquakes and the planetary geometry. These are the red peaks that we see consistently with seismic activity. So this is what we do. We analyze the planetary geometry and we anticipate large earthquakes. It is also interesting to observe that from the 11th, during the entire week, there were no earthquakes in the high 5 magnitude range. The only one, 5.7, occurred on the 12th, but throughout the week, no earthquakes in the high 5 magnitude range. So other than the strong earthquakes that we had, it was relatively quiet. So let's have a look at the planetary and lunar geometry that we're going to have in the coming week. If we look at the SSGI graph, we see primarily lunar geometry throughout the week. These are the green peaks. And interestingly, tomorrow we're going to have a new moon that will be later on the 21st. And it will be followed several hours later by one planetary conjunction. It will be the Sun, Mercury and Jupiter. If you look at the solar system, we can actually see this geometry. The green line is the new moon that will be later on the 21st, later tomorrow. And then several hours later, there is a near convergence. There is the Sun, Mercury and Jupiter conjunction. And this could become a little bit more critical. Normally with a full or a new moon, we don't necessarily see larger seismic activity. But if it converges with specific planetary geometry, then it can become a little bit more critical. It doesn't mean that we're going to have a big quake. To be honest, I do not expect that. But we could see a seismic increase, maybe into the mid-6 magnitude range, possibly around the 22nd, as a result of this planetary and lunar geometry. Atmospheric fluctuations that we picked up, they were not too convincing. They were actually a little bit vague, but I will show them to you anyway. In some region, India, there was a fluctuation. And also over Iran, Iraq, over Africa, the Mediterranean, and also the South Sandwich Islands region, the Atlantic Ridge. And then a few days ago, we also picked up fluctuations over Central America and the Southeast Pacific Rise. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.